the Collins Dictionary designated fake news as one of its words of 2017, and it's a favored topic of U.S. President Donald Trump, but do you know fake news when you see it? Check these 15 brief news reports and choose whether they were genuine or bogus. Scroll to the bottom of this page for more detail on the featured stories. Year in review, the TV shows that changed our lives for the better in 2017 year in review, the good news stories you may have missed in 2017 year in review, the questions that still haunt us at the end of 20,171. Carrie Fisher had heroin in her system at the time of her death. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. Carrie Fisher's autopsy report, released in June, showed the actor had cocaine, ecstasy and heroin in her system at the time of her death, aged 60 in late 2016. Investigators could not determine whether the drug cocktail killed her, but they did reveal Fisher may have taken cocaine 3 days before the December 23 flight on which she became ill. She died 4 days later. Point 2. U.S. diplomats in Havana complained that they were subject to mysterious sonic attacks that left them with headaches and hearing problems this year, but Cuban authorities said the attacks were just the noisy mating sounds of cicadas and crickets. Was this fake news or real news? Real. NEWSA. As bizarre as it sounds, this all happened, and it has been a long-running source of distrust between the U.S. and Cuba. CNN reported that 20 U.S. diplomats were tested and symptoms ranged from hearing loss to dizziness, visual complaints, fatigue and difficulty sleeping. Cuban state TV suggested the diplomats' health issues could have been brought on by the noises from crickets and cicadas. Point 3. A PC movement in the UK called for Father Christmas to be given the gender-neutral moniker, Person Christmas. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. This story went viral in the lead up to Christmas, but it was just a fun yarn cooked up by UK social news website Unilad. There were in fact no gender activists calling for Father Christmas to be renamed in a more gender-inclusive way. Point 4. A cavity as big as a Boeing aeroplane was found in the Great Pyramid of Giza this year. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. Archaeologists made the discovery in November, using imaging technology similar to X-rays. The 30-meter chamber has not yet been accessed, and its purpose, if it even has one, remains unclear. Point 5. Melania Trump used a body double in at least one press conference with her husband, U.S. President Donald Trump, this year. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. Melania Trump is known for her low profile, so the preposterous idea that she may have dipped out of public events altogether and sent a body double along instead appealed to many when the conspiracy theory surfaced in October. The rumor started when Twitter users claimed that the woman with oversized sunglasses standing next to U.S. President Donald Trump during a press conference on the South Lawn of the White House was an imposter. It was a hoot, but alas, not real. Point 6. The Kardashian girls are all pregnant at the same time. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. Mostly, as unlikely as it sounds, at least two Kardashians are definitely expected to welcome new babies in 2018. Khloe confirmed she was pregnant with her first child in December, while Kim and husband Kanye West have engaged a surrogate for their third baby, who is reportedly due in January. Kim and Khloe's stepsister Kylie Jenner is also expected to confirm reports she is pregnant to rapper Travis Scott very soon. Point 7. Barnaby Joyce brought a whip to the Canberra parliamentary ball in June. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. The Deputy Prime Minister accessorized his tuxedo with an akubra and a bull whip for the Federal Parliament midwinter ball, and even demonstrated his prowess with the whip in the building's marble foyer. Point 8. Kid Rock is preparing to run for the U.S. Senate. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. Singer Kid Rock teased a possible Senate run for several months in 2017, producing campaign paraphernalia and giving a series of political speeches during concerts, but in October he revealed the whole thing was a publicity stunt. "Are you kidding me?" the singer told radio shock jock Howard Stern. "Who couldn't figure that out? I'm releasing a new album. I'm going on tour, too." 9. The CIA investigated a tip-off from Canberra in the wake of the Kennedy assassination in 1963. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. The release of nearly 3,000 documents relating to the Kennedy assassination in October this year revealed that the CIA investigated a series of calls made to the U.S. Embassy in Canberra from a man known only as the Polish driver. The man contacted the embassy 3 times, the first time in 1960 with apparently correct information about high-ranking American officials who had defected to the Soviet Union, and again in 1962, although the record of the conversation has been lost. the same man is believed to have called the embassy again a day after JFK's assassination, claiming to have knowledge about a Soviet plot to assassinate President Kennedy. The CIA concluded that the caller was probably a crank, but they were never able to identify who he was. 10. Bachelorette Sophie Monk and winner Stu Londi had already broken up by the time the finale of the show went to air. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. Sophie Monk was a magnet for false news reports throughout 2017, battling rumors that she was pregnant and that she and Bachelorette winner Stu Londi had already split up by the time the series went to air. Pictures of the couple were dissected by gossip writers with a level of scrutiny that bordered on the forensic, but recent paparazzi images of the couple show that they are still hanging out, holidaying together in Canada over Christmas. 11. Pauline Hanson was personally invited to Donald Trump's inauguration as U.S. president. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. Pauline Hanson boasted on Twitter that she had been gifted tickets to the January 20th inauguration, suggesting she was in the new administration's favor, but it was subsequently revealed that the party had begged for tickets through the Australian embassy in Washington. Republican Senator Adam Kinzinger gifted the tickets to the embassy to use as they wish. South Australian One Nation Senator Brian Burston and his partner were the eventual recipients of the tickets. 12. A severed foot encased in a running shoe washed up on the shore near Vancouver, the 18th time this has happened in the past decade. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. Severed human feet encased in running shoes have been discovered along the coast of the Salish Sea between Canada and the US for the past decade, generating countless theories but no definitive answers. The 18 feet and shoes found, only two have been matched together. Despite the grisly coincidence, forensic experts believe the feet may all belong to suicide victims, and the running shoes protected the feet even while other parts of the body have fallen away. 13. The photo of a Muslim woman walking past injured victims shortly after the lone wolf terrorist attack on London's Westminster Bridge went viral because of a Russian bot. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. More correctly, this was real news about fake news. The image of the Muslim woman was widely shared on social media after the March attack, but in November it was revealed that the Twitter account that first shared the image had been traced back to a Russian bot factory. It should also be noted that the woman in the image was not ignoring the victims, as some people claimed, but was notifying her family that was safe in the aftermath of the traumatic event. 14. Police in the U.S. launched a homicide investigation into the death of Linkin Park singer Chester Bennington. Was this fake news or real news? Fake news. This bogus story did the rounds on social media in July. The article looked at parallels between Bennington's suicide that same month and the death of Soundgarden frontman Chris Cornell, who took his own life in May. According to the article, Cornell had been close to exposing a network of pedophiles within the entertainment industry, and both deaths were made to look like suicides. But both deaths were officially ruled suicides by the Los Angeles County Coroner, and no homicide investigation was launched. 15. In a story about Donald Trump's and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, a newspaper in the Dominican Republic mistakenly ran a photo of Alec Baldwin impersonating Trump, rather than an image of the president. Was this fake news or real news? Real news. Is indeed, the El Nacional newspaper did make this egregious boo-boo, apologizing to readers and anyone who felt affected by the publication, the next day.